in Australia. Good morning, I should have said. In Australia, they have a long-distance race that is run between Melbourne and Sydney, Australia. It's about 400 miles. Back in the 1970s, they were going to have the race, and when the contestants showed up, they came from all over the world. But one of them showed up. He was an Australian farmer. He was wearing bib overalls and overshoes. And when he ran, he didn't lift his feet. He just shuffled along. And everybody looked at him and they laughed at him. And they asked him, how did you learn to run long distances? And he said, well, I live on this ranch out in the hinterlands, and I don't have any vehicle. And the way I run down my cattle and my sheep, or my cattle and my pigs, and all my other things, is by just chasing them. And I chase them all day, all over my ranch. And that's how I learned to run long distances. And everybody laughed and thought it was funny that this guy would be entering himself in this world-class distance race. And so they started the race. And when they had run about 8 hours, all of the professional runners, they quit. But this old man, he just kept running. He was about 60 years old, and he just kept running. He ran, and they told him he needed to stop, and he just didn't listen. He just ran all day. And the next morning, when all the people who were good runners showed up, he was somewhat ahead of them, and he continued to run. And that night, they all stopped after about 8 hours, and he just kept running. He ran all that day, or all that night, and all the next day. And now he was miles ahead. In fact, he was hours ahead of all the other runners. And he finally kept running, and he finally was arriving at Sydney. And he was going to come in very early in the morning. And the TV cameras wanted him to wait, take a rest, and come in on prime time. But he refused to, and he just kept running. And when he won the race, he won it by 17 hours. Now, it was interesting. The next year, when they ran the race, somebody beat his record. What was the difference? There was a new paradigm that was developed about how you run races. And when it was discovered, the way you could keep running, you just didn't have to follow the old paradigms, that there were new paradigms that could make life happen, it changed the way they ran. And the same thing is true about living. We can have a new paradigm. And when Jesus of Nazareth came into this world, he brought with him a new paradigm of what the human condition was, and what humans could be, and what they could dream to be, and what God wanted them to be. And as people began to follow his formula, they discovered that they could be everything they dreamed of and all that God wanted them to be. And I know myself that I'm as far superior man than I would have been if I hadn't learned to walk in the paths of the Master. And I would want to encourage you to give consideration to this kind of ability so that you can change the paradigms of how you see life. God bless you.